Hello friends, so today I'm going to review Apple Studio Mobile on Xperia Z5. It's the best digital audio workstation for Android device till date and also capable for creating industry level music on the go. So let's start with new project. You can see here. In the starting we got drum sequencer here. Let's play it. Let's add some stuff. So created a basic loop here. So after that, by long tapping on this kick button, we got load samples in which we can select the type of kick we wanna use. And by just simply tapping on this kick button, we got several settings like volume control, we can control panning, we can make it solo or we can turn it off, and we also can control pitch of the kick, and we can control length of the kick, and we can control attack, sustain, release, and so many settings are there. So after that, here you can see a small button there. Let's expand it, and in this we can control volume, panning, and pitch for this particular kick. So that was horizontal setting, and this is vertical setting. So enough creativity options are there and you can do all this thing in all part of drums, like a snare and other part of drums. So let's close it. So after that you can expand it to infinity by just simply dragging it. So here we can show. So after drum sequencer, let's see some other options in track part. Here you can see an add button. Let's see what's in it. So by tapping on add button, we got several instrument options. Let's select one and let's select guitar. And after selecting instrument, we got piano roll. So you can play instrument by using this piano roll, or you can also use this virtual keyboard. And if you are not comfortable with both of these things, you can also connect external MIDI keyboard by using a USB OTG cable. But yeah, that's not for on the go work, but still it's a good option. Let's see some other options. So you can add audio clip from this device, you can record audio from aux cable, or you can record audio from this microphone, the microphone of this phone. So enough options are there, but one option is missing. Let me open my project so that I can show you that. So here's my project. Let me make it solo. So yeah, the automation track. So the automation track is basically is a time-based control over main track. We can put a effect on this track and we can control it manually. For example, we can see here I put it volume effect here, and the upper diagram showing the volume level up and the lower part of this diagram showing the volume level down. So I'm creating this diagram for alternating sound. You can listen. So this alternative sound is created by this automation track. So automation track is very important in any DAW. So after that, let's come to mixer part. Here we got a mixer in which we can control panning, we can control volume, and For virtual keyboard, we have modulation setting, pitch control, and we also have double deck virtual keyboard. Let's close it. And in the center, we have play, rewind, record, and metronome buttons. And let's come to the right part. So in the right part, we got effect rack. It's very important rack because effect is very important for any DAW. So let's see what's in it. So in the effect rack, we got all type of popular effect like reverb, tape delay, trans delay, distortion, compressor, limiter, equalizer, and all popular effects are there. But one of my favorite is this multi effects pad. In this we can control any type of effect by using this virtual graphical interface in real time. So it is so easy to use it and very creative also. And the color of this effect track will be the same of its track, so we can identify it easily. So let's close it. So in the top right corner we got main menu, in which we have our recent projects and some preloaded projects. In settings we can control MIDI, the external MIDI I was talking about, and we can control metronome levels, etc. And we can also shop some sounds from image line server. And in the last we can share our project. And in the top corner, the help button allowing you to go online for assistance. And here in the left hand side we have a snap button. So that's all. That is basic of this software. So some people found it hard to interact in this small screen, especially for this kind of complicated software. But I think hats off to ImageLine engineers who created every aspect of this software is expandable. For example, you can see here the track part is expandable. We can control volume and other aspects. Mixer is expandable. Virtual keyboard is expandable. And effect rack is expandable. So at least I'm not feeling any kind of problem by using it on the go. And come on, you have to be a little adjustable. You are producing music on the go in by just having 119 grams of weight in your hands. So thank you for watching this video. It is advised that to use this software yourself and you will learn it better. Thank you.
Trust me.